GTFO is a kind of game that we haven't seen around in quite some time. Yo, how's it going, everyone? My name is GatorDude. Welcome to my channel. I appreciate each and every one of you watching this video. Let's just get right into it. So GTFO has really been blowing up, and I feel like I wanted to give it my own try for a little bit and branch out and just play a little bit more variety. Yeah, so I figured that I wanted to try GTFO and just branch out and play a little bit of variety as well. And I've really been enjoying this game. I think that the game is challenging. I think it's hard. I think it's very rewarding when you actually finally get to accomplish stuff, which is something that I haven't felt in a game in forever, mainly because I spend the majority of my time playing multiplayer games such as, you know, Halo or Fortnite or anything like that. But this is not a multiplayer game. Well, it is a multiplayer game, but it's not a competitive, you know, multiplayer game. It's cooperative. So you're playing together, you're trying to solve the puzzle. Now, me and my buddy were playing the other night, and by my buddy, I mean my cousin. We were playing the other night, last night to be exact, and we were having a freaking blast playing this game. The only thing about it is that it is extremely difficult if you do not have a full squad. So the game is set up with all the equipment. You're gonna need somebody that has each and every piece of equipment, almost. That's at least how the game feels, right? It was just me and just my cousin playing for about 2 hours straight, and I couldn't believe how hard the game was. I mean, the first game we could barely get past, like the first checkpoint. We couldn't even really get past the first set of doors because we just got overrun by the freaking monsters. But at the same time, this is kind of like a puzzle game, and I really do enjoy the puzzle aspect of it. I love that you have to sneak around and be super careful about where you're going and what you're doing. You have to be very aware of what your objective is, and that's a great feeling in this game. I want to continue playing this game and learning this game. I have not beaten any mission in this game so far, so I'm looking to squad up with some more people, you know, dive back into it, see if we can finally accomplish this mission. But the mission I was on was absolutely insane. I couldn't even believe it, man. I mean, there were so many times where I made the smallest mistake and it just cost us the entire match. One time we had opened a brand new set of doors that we hadn't even opened before, and before I knew it, there was a swarm of freaking creatures just surrounding us, and I was like, oh my god, how did this happen? Turns out my cousin had his ability out, and he was using his ability and still holding down left click, went to his primary gun and shot one bullet by accident. That alerted the entire army of creatures, and we got overrun in absolutely no time. Like, oh my god, what the hell is going on here, dude? Yeah, that's how this game feels. So you're on edge the entire time. If you take the time, or if you give yourself the slack and you start slacking off and paying less attention to the things around you, you're gonna be like, wow, dude, wow, really? I'm already dead this quick? Are you shitting me? Yep, that's gonna be your entire existence on GTFO. So for this game, you have to take it very slow. You have to know exactly what's going on at all times. You have to be very, very aware. If you make the smallest mistake, it could cost you the entire match. Now, some people might think that's a problem with the game, and some people might think that's a plus to the game. I am one of those people who I feel like it's a plus to the game. I feel like the challenge is going to make beating the puzzles a lot more rewarding than if they just let us beat the puzzles, no problem. You know what I mean? Does that make sense? By the way, anybody that's new here, that's enjoying this video, feel free to hit that subscribe button. I really do appreciate each and every one of you. Let's continue. So when me and my buddy were running through the game, we were both running the Seafoam launcher. That's about the only way that we could get through the objectives and stuff, is having the Seafoam launcher and slowing down the enemies. So when they do finally break through the initial barricade, we can still hold off and still shoot them all while we're waiting for the new gate to open. Yeah, so we both decided to use the Seafoam, and the Seafoam was a great option for us. It actually came in clutch many different times throughout our matches the other night. We played for about 2.5 hours, And yeah, the Seafoam launcher, rocking double Seafoam, worked out pretty well. The only problem with that is like I said, rocking only two people in GTFO is really hard. And it's honestly pretty damn impossible because you need one of those people that has the radar that's going to scan around for the enemies that are around so you don't make the mistake of accidentally walking into one or walking right by one and alerting the entire squad, the entire creatures, the hell spawns that they are, you know? So yeah, I mean, the Seafoam is great. I love the Sentry Turret is a great ability as well. But the radar is honestly, it's the most informative, I feel like. So whoever's rocking the radar in this game is going to find everything. And they're going to be able to not only tag, but call out those creatures so you're not walking into them by accident. Now, this game is, you know, it's great. I think it just came out in December, and I'm looking forward to what they're doing with the game. Personally, though, I feel like this game should be a little bit easier, or they should adjust the difficulty based on how many players you have, because playing with two people is impossible, because you're playing pretty much against the same size horde as you would have played with a four-player squad, but you have to handle it with two people. So I feel like they should adjust either the amount of enemies that they have coming at you when you're playing with only two players, or they should adjust the health and make it easier for them to kill. Because, oh my god, it is, like I said, it's impossible to play with two people. That is the only problem with this game, is if you don't have a full squad, the game is much more challenging than it should be, and not near as fun. But with that being said, I have played some matches with a full squad, and it was a lot easier. And I had, and the chances of winning is just so much higher, you know. But with that said, I did get the chance to actually play with a full squad. So, you know, playing with a full squad is great. I absolutely love it. And like I said, I did have the chance to play with a full squad. So I absolutely love the idea of squadding up. The only problem is finding people to play in your full squad whenever you want to play the game is hard to coordinate. I mean, everybody just has to be in the mood for GTFO. And I know there's ways to find squads. I know there's Discord servers and, you know, places like that. Which brings me to my next point, guys. I do stream on twitch.tv, which is where all this gameplay did come from for the video. If you guys want to hop in my lobbies, if you want to join my GTFO matches, feel free to hit me up over there. I'm more than happy to play with anybody and everybody that wants to play this game. I want to explore it, and I want to explore it the right way. But thank you all for watching. I do appreciate it. The overall consensus of this game is that it's great. It's challenging. It's hard. With a full squad, it is way better. Don't even bother really playing the game if you don't have a full squad. That's unfortunate that I have to say that, but the game is just so challenging right now that that's just the case. But if anybody wants to play, hit me up on Twitter, Discord. All my social medias are going to be down below. I do appreciate each and every one of you watching this video, but thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.